What's up, gamers? In this video, I'm going to be showing you the best way to get a shiny Charizard and how to really increase your chances in order to do this, and the best Pokemon you can use to breed with the Charizard you got from your Tera raid event, or if you didn't, how to breed with the Charmander in order to get your shiny Pokemon that looks lovely. Let's get into it. So the Charizard raid event gave us no opportunities to have a shiny Charizard show up because it was completely locked, and some people may like that and some people don't. I fall into the category of I wish there was a shiny Charizard raid, but the other people would argue that, you know, people would leave if it wasn't shiny Charizard, and that would cause chaos online because you could only catch one. So the simple solution is that you have to breed your Charizard in order to get the shiny. That's the only way to get it as of right now, because Pokemon Home compatibility isn't here as of this video, but here is exactly the best way of doing it. So the most common way people are going to start breeding is by using a regular Ditto and a Charizard that they find in their game, but unfortunately, the chances of you getting a shiny Pokemon from that fall under 1 out of 4,096. That's not so hot, and you might be there forever breeding your Pokemon. The second option is to use that Ditto with a shiny charm, and that's going to only get you a 1 out of 2,048 chance. Not so hot either. The third way of doing this is going to be with the Masuda method. This one's my favorite one. All you need is basically a foreign Ditto. But listen, I know how complicated sometimes it is to get a foreign Ditto. So there's other foreign Pokemon options you have. And by the way, when I mean foreign, I just mean the game has to be a different language than yours. You could even make a separate profile and do this by catching certain Pokemon in a different language in order to pull this off. Okay, so according to Bulbapedia, here is Charmander's dex entry, right? I'm gonna show you how to do this. Basically, you wanna look at the egg groups that it's in. Now, we already know Ditto you can breed with any Pokemon, but there are other things you can use to breed with as well. You have the monster egg group and the dragon egg group. And basically, you can even get a Pokemon in a different language that falls under any of these two egg groups over here. In the monster egg group, these are the Pokemon that exist in this one. And you can see that Larvitar, this is a Pokemon Scarlet exclusive. It also has the dragon egg group, which I'm going to show you here. If you have Pokemon Violet, you do have Bagons to breed with. You have Salamences, Shelgon, so you can use those. If you're Pokemon Scarlet, you can use Dino, Zvelis, or Hydreigon. Everyone has access to Goodra in their game. So those are some dragon Pokemon that you can use to breed with your Charmander. So get those in another language. It does not have to be just Ditto, so you don't have to worry about that as well. The cool part about the Masuda method is that it is a 1 out of 683 chance, which is very low without even a shiny charm. But if you do add on the shiny charm to that, that's going to bring you to about a 1 out of 512 chance of getting it shiny. Now, if you want to take this even further and breed the most perfect and optimized Charmander or Charizard, there's a lot of breeding mechanisms that you can do, and that involves putting the item Destiny Knot on the Pokemon with 6 IVs. Luckily, if you have the Charizard Pokemon from the event, that is able to then pass on a combination of its IVs with the Pokemon you're breeding with. So that's a great Pokemon to start with. And if you have a Ditto that is 6 IV along with the Charizard that is 6 IV, you're always guaranteed 5 IV babies with a 1 out of 32 chance of getting a 6 IV Pokemon. Again, it doesn't have to be just the Ditto. It could be any of the Pokemon I mentioned. As long as they are 6 IV breeding with a 6 IV with the Destiny Knot, you should be good. If you want to pass down the nature without spending money on ability patches, just go ahead and slap on an Everstone to your Pokemon, and that should pass down the nature, and you should be able to hatch a shiny Charmander that you should be able to get all the way up. It took me over 600 eggs to finally get this Charmander, which I was really happy about. My wife and I took turns, so she was taking the night shift and hatching a bunch of eggs. I woke up, I started hatching eggs. Now, I made videos on breeding and the specifics of it, so if you want to check that out, you can watch this video over here.